good to see so many people here tonight. We're so thankful for our band. I'll thank you later again. We're so grateful. If this is your first time at Sankofa, Wisconsin, will you raise your hand? Great. If you've been to one before, will you raise your hand? Good. Well, everybody raise both hands. Put them together. Yeah, you got to use them tonight, okay? I turned around and I'm like, what am I in, a museum? Come on, you got to enjoy yourselves. Completely enjoy yourself. This is one place that we often talk about for Sankofa is this is where you can unapologetically be you and respond to music like a baby would do. Baby hears music, they respond to it. They don't go, oh, that sounds nice. No, no, they immediately start tapping beats, all of the beats, until they learn which ones are up and down, and then they just enjoy themselves. So I ask that you all just feel free. I also want to publicly say that I am so grateful to have Ronnie, who is the graduate assistant, also the assistant conductor, co-conductor. We have all these titles for Ronnie, but he's the person who helped keep this moving. So thank you. So next, I'm going to invite Ronnie up to conduct the next piece. Thank you.
Sure. Anyone ever heard of Stevie Wonder? Yeah. Maybe not. Yeah, so this song is Love's in Need of Love Today. In a world such as ours on today, when we're seeking meaning and we're seeking peace, I could say that our love can maybe use a little bit more. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah.
So that's essentially what this is. Love's in Need of Love Today. Please enjoy. The force of evil plans to make you its possession, and it will, if we let it, destroy everybody. We all must take precautionary.
How you doing tonight? All right, good. So you've been sitting down for a while. On this song, I would like you to stand on up, okay? Yeah. Some crowd participation, let's move a little bit. Sankofa, one of the things about this choir is we like to highlight the music and the music of the Black experience. And in our culture, music or concerts aren't just a spectator sport. It's more so interactive. So you can clap, you can yell someone's name, you can say sing. That helps us. That actually pushes and encourages the choir. So when we see you clap or when we see you say yeah, that encourages us to go even further. So this song, no matter your religious affiliation, everybody is one word, blessed. Say blessed.
Blessed.
Good, good, good. So that's all we're gonna say. That's your part. Say it again, blessed.
Blessed.
But let's pitch it. Let's tune it. E flat. Everybody say blessed and
blessed.
Come on.
Blessed.
Come on.
Blessed.
Blessed. Rock.
Blessed.
Come on, it's rock.
Blessed. Blessed.
Come on, move.
Blessed.
Blessed. Everybody say
blessed.
Yes, we are.
We're blessed when we come and when we go.
We're blessed.
We
That is part of, as soon as you feel it, it just takes you out of whatever state of mind you're in. Don't you agree? I mean, I'm sure we got homework due tomorrow. I'm sure we got some practicing we could be doing in the school of music. I'm sure there's some emails our director could be doing. Lots of things that could be happening tonight. Bills need to be paid, and paid again, and paid on time, all of those things. But in the essence of what this group and we constantly talk about is, this is a place 2 hours a week for sure. This is a free therapy session for them. And it's music therapy. And I must say that I thank my ancestors for their gift to us. They endured a life of pain, hardship that we could never, ever, ever imagine. But they gifted us with this. I don't know if you've ever had a child in your life. I haven't. But I heard that it's pretty aggressive in a lot of ways. I was trying to use the best word I could think of, but through all that agony and some experiences of that, you birth a child that you could love like no other person in the world. That's why you hope for them to be the best they could absolutely be. And so when I look at the music of the Black experience, I think about the slaves that endured so much. So I'm sure the least they could say is, know that it came from our hardships, but appreciate it and respect it and allow it to have its space in every space you allow any other music to be. And why wouldn't we? Why wouldn't we? Because we lose this. I love Bach and I love Beethoven, but none of them can get me like this. I mean, I'm sorry, I don't get the little bubblies. I mean, I love the ornamentations. I love all of that. I'm sure period instruments and all that is wonderful. But there's nothing quite like someone expressing music through their soul. Got it? I don't have to go and say, who's this religion, and who's that religion, and who's this religion, and who's not religious at all. Doesn't matter. It really doesn't, you know? So, I know we watch a lot of stories on I'm giving them a little break if you want to know why I'm talking to you. Because you give so much that you vocally get tired, don't you agree? Well, maybe not. Okay, well, get on up. Here we go. No. But anyway, I like to say that Sankofa, can I invite Angela up? When I decided that this would be an ensemble, I wanted to start. I was in Hamburg, Germany, and I got an email or text from Ronnie telling me about this young lady who sang Wade in the Water in her audition that I had to hear because we were starting Sankofa. And Angela has been, she's kind of like the mother of the choir. Well, the aunt of the choir. In those kind of things, well, you know, grandmothers can be young, but we won't talk about that anyway. I want to say that this is just, she's brought to the ensemble a sort of very much so understanding of what Sankofa means. For us, we think it means heritage, which I think that's close for us in the U.S., heritage. But I'd like for Angela to give us a little bit more context since she is from Ghana.
So unfortunately, Dr. Boyd, I will have to correct you on one thing. It's not Sankofa, it's Sankofa. Can everybody say it with me, Sankofa? Thank you. If I hear one more Sankofa, I'm going to lose my mind. But it is Sankofa, and it does have to do with heritage. But an added part is, if anybody has ever seen the symbol is of a bird, which has its feet pointed forward while its head turned back. And the symbolism of that is no matter where you're going, you need to know your heritage to continue on. So it's not just about looking back, it is also about moving forward and about the future. So, yeah. And so today, because it's so close to Mother's Day, I'm sorry, fathers, we want to celebrate mothers a little bit. And the song that we're going to sing is from Prince Nico. And the funny thing is, I realized only this week that on that same album that he has Sweet Mother, there's a song called Good Father. None of us have ever heard it. But Sweet Mother is so popular during its time, and it's still huge in all over Africa. And Chris Nico is originally from Nigeria. And the song is actually in English, but it's in Nigerian Pidgin, which is classified as its own language. And so today, y'all are gonna help me out a little bit. I will translate what it is. So it goes, Sweet Mother, I no go forget you, which pretty much say, Sweet Mother, I will never forget you. So, Sweet Mother, I no go forget you.
Sweet Mother, I no go forget you.
Okay, one more time. Sweet Mother, I no go forget you.
Sweet Mother, I no go forget you.
Perfect. For the suffer way you suffer for me. I'm going to repeat it. For the suffer way you suffer for me. Go. For the suffer way you suffer for me. Okay, so let's start from the beginning. Sweet Mother, I no go forget you. For the suffer way you suffer for me. Go. Sweet Mother, I no go forget you. For the suffer way you suffer for me. Okay, perfect. So I will sing a little bit of the song. Y'all are gonna repeat anytime I start that part. Please join. And I will need you up, but just sit down for a second. Let me teach you. So it goes, Sweet Mother, I no go forget you. Ready, go. Sweet Mother, I no go forget you. Perfect. For this suffer way you suffer for me, yeah. For this suffer way you suffer for me, yeah. Okay, from the top. Sweet Mother, I no go forget you. For this suffer way you suffer for me, yeah. Repeat. Sweet Mother, I no go forget you. For this suffer way you suffer for me. Perfect. Get the beat in. If y'all can get up, come on. Hey. And do your best moves. Come on. Hey, hey, hey.
Stop. Preach.
Change. question is,
do you wanna be happy?
If you're tired of you, then look at yourself and say,
I just wanna be happy.
All right, now if you mean that, let me hear you say, took a long time, but I'm ready.
I just wanna be happy.
Thank you, Lord. Every day, just say, every day.
Do you wanna be happy?
I just wanna be happy.
Thank you.
last one is called Lord, I Owe You, which is written by Christopher Watkins, who is from St. Louis, Missouri. So we've done the piece before, and we think it's a great closer. We hope you like it. I'm letting them breathe again. So just get ready for the last piece. Publicly, I will say we're so proud of you, Ron, and I both are so very, very proud of you and so grateful for you and just thankful. And we say it a lot, but it's never too much. Thank you for all the time you put in. Thank you for the bassists who have to get a different bass part every week because we make it up. But they don't mind. They just migrate to tenor eventually. But we're so grateful. Thank you, band, so much for your participation in this. Thank you. We really do appreciate you, and we appreciate your presence tonight. You being in this room brings about an energy that we really need, and we do appreciate. So, hey, Donna. Good to see you. So how many of you are students here at the University of Missouri? Will you raise your hand? Great. Fabulous. Thank you. How many School of Music faculty members do we have here? Dr. Sims is here. Yay. Any other School of Music faculty members? Great. We have staff members. Yes, staff members. Susan, thank you so much. We thank all of you because the academic courses that our music majors take are very as important as our ensembles, but we do know that they just all have their function within our existence as students, as faculty members, here as an academic institution. All of them have their places. I mean, this is an outlet for them while they have their courses that kind of enrich their minds to think very differently about music. And we're grateful for all of our faculty and staff members who help us organize when concerts will be, where they'll be. It's a lot of work that happens to get to this place. It's not as easy as somebody might think. Oh, when did y'all rehearse? Every week. 2 hours, you know? You sometimes come. Have you ever been here and really needed to be doing your homework?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of times. You really think, I should be doing my homework. So we're so grateful. Last piece is, and I'll let Ronnie introduce it, because we have a wonderful soloist who I am so happy for you to be able to experience her again. She was in our opening pieces, but I'll let Ronnie introduce her for our last piece. Oh, Lord, I Owe You.
Yeah, last piece. Lakeisha. I met this young lady when I am also the artist in residence at Columbia College, and we did a concert there. Hey, Cece. And we did a concert there, and she sang a solo, and I was like, I don't know who you are, but if you're in the vicinity of MU, I need you. Hey, that rhymes, right? And she was like, her answer was, I'm ready to work. And so I wanted to present to everybody Miss Nakisha Long.